Good morning and welcome to our service of reflection for the National Day of Reflection, when we are marking the first anniversary of the start of the first lockdown, which I'm sure we all remember quite vividly. I think it's a bit like when President Kennedy died. You remember where you were when you heard that we were going into lockdown. And we remember also all those who have died, all those who have suffered with COVID and thankfully survived. We think of all those who have suffered with COVID and are still suffering the ill effects now. I'm going to begin with a prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, when fear and anxiety besiege us and hope is veiled in grief, hold us in your wounded hands and make your face shine on us again, for you are our Lord and God. Amen. Going to play a piece of music now, a worship song, and you may be wondering why I'm choosing a worship song, which we tend to think of them as being all hands in the air and praising God, and maybe that seems inappropriate, but I think when you read the lyrics that will come up on the screen, you will understand something of why I've chosen this song. It is by Matt Redman, and it's called Blessed Be Your Name.
Blessed be your name of the Lord.
you will agree with me that that is a beautiful worship song. And just to give you a little bit of background of Matt Redman, who wrote it, he and his wife experienced a lot of pain through losing several babies by miscarriage. And in fact, Matt Redman's father committed suicide when he was seven. So they experienced a lot of pain in amongst the joy of being Christians. And I think that that is something that we can all relate to in this time of COVID. We are Christians, we are trying to keep our faith going, and we're trying to trust in God, but it has seemed incredibly bleak at times. And I think that we all now sadly know somebody who has had COVID, and some of us know people who have died from COVID. And so we've been in that place where we're having to choose to praise God. We're having to choose to stay faithful to him. We're having to choose to trust in him. As Matt expressed so beautifully in that song, I'm going to say some of the prayers that have been provided by the Church of England now for this day of reflection. So will you join with me in prayer? Firstly, a prayer for all those affected by coronavirus. Keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy in this time of uncertainty and distress. Sustain and support the anxious and fearful, and lift up all who are brought low, that we may rejoice in your comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love in Jesus Christ our Lord. And a prayer for all who mourn. And this is not just for people who are mourning the loss of somebody to COVID, but for anyone who has lost a loved one during this past year. Gracious God, as we remember before you the thousands who have died, surround us and all who mourn with your strong compassion. Be gentle with us in our grief. Protect us from despair, and give us grace to persevere and face the future with hope in Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. And a prayer remembering the departed. Lord of all, we praise you for all whom we love but see no longer, all who have entered into their rest. Give us grace to follow in their footsteps as they followed in the way of your Son. Thank you for the memory of those you have called to yourself. By each memory, turn our hearts from things seen to things unseen, and lead us till we come to the eternal rest you have prepared for your people, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we gather our prayers together in the collect for this week. Most merciful God, who by the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, delivered and saved the world, grant that by faith in him who suffered on the cross, we may triumph in the power of his victory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We are now drawing close to the time of the 1 minute silence, and use this time to draw near to God, to remember those who you don't know, who none of us know, the thousands who have died from COVID. But also use it as a time to remember your loved ones, maybe in the last year or maybe further back. If you have lost somebody in the last year, it will have been a particularly difficult time to grieve. We haven't had the funerals that we wanted. We haven't been able to say goodbye to our loved ones in the way that we wanted. So take a moment now just to remember them as we keep silence for 1 minute. Heavenly Father, we lift up to you all those who we have loved and lost in this past year and throughout our lives. We lift up to you all those who have died from COVID, those known to us and unknown to us. We pray for their families and friends who will be grieving at this same time around the country. We pray that you will bring peace and comfort into the lives of all who grieve. And Lord, we grieve not just for the loss of people, but we grieve for the loss of liberty. Even if we don't know anyone who has died, we grieve the loss of time spent with family and friends. We grieve the loss of our workplaces. We lift up to you our loneliness and our isolation during these past months. And we lift up to you our fear, Lord, our fear for the future of what will come after we come out of lockdown again. We fear, Lord, that it may not be the last lockdown. We fear new variants. And yet, Lord, we have hope. In the midst of all of this uncertainty, we have hope. We see the sun coming out. We know that you give us a new day each morning. We see how you bless us in the natural world around us. You give us hope in the vaccines. You give us hope in our NHS. Lord, we remember all those around the world who are not receiving vaccines as quickly as we are. We pray for them and we give you thanks that our government has managed such an amazing rollout of vaccines. Lord, be in our plans for the future. Help us to keep our eyes fixed on you. To trust in you, to choose to trust in you, even when times seem dark. Lord, as we journey towards the cross this Easter, it seems so appropriate, really. We are in that strange place at the moment of still being in lockdown and yet with hope on the horizon. Perhaps this year more than any, we are experiencing the lead up to Easter Sunday in some small measure in the way that Jesus felt it, in the way the disciples felt it. Lord, let us look to the future. Help us to remember that whatever happens, you are always there. You never let go of us. You keep us safe in your embrace. And whether safe means safe on this earth or whether safe means safe in heaven with you, Lord, we are assured of a place with you. So let our hearts choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. Amen. I'm going to finish now with another Matt Redman song, and this one is You Never Let Go.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? That is coming for the heart that holds on.
Loving God, as we journey towards Easter, help us to live as people of hope, knowing that beyond the pain of the cross lies the joy of resurrection. Inspire us in our worship, through our churches and in our homes, that we may bring glory to you and joy to others. Be with those who are struggling in mind, body, or spirit, and give courage to those who are facing uncertainty and change ahead. Help each of us to keep our eyes fixed on you, that we may reflect your light to all whom we meet. Amen. You may wish to light a candle at 8 o'clock this evening to remember those who have died. Put it in your window, or perhaps a lantern or a lamp. And there is a prayer which I have emailed out, which you can say, or you can find it on the Church of England website. God bless you.